This is Mr. Hanson. I thought I'd show my face for the first time, along with the slideshow, to make it more personal. In this video, I will talk about social roles and gender identity, and how they develop in childhood. A social role is expected behavior of a certain social category or social group in society. And a very common social role is your gender identity or your gender role. And your gender identity is whether you identify as a man or a woman. Some people believe that there is a strong correlation between your gender and your biological sex. Your biological sex can be defined as what type of sex chromosome you have, whether you have an XY chromosome or an XX chromosome. And as I said, some people believe that whether you identify being a man or woman, or whether you have traditionally masculine or feminine behavior, that this depends on your sex. And why does it do that though? Because they think your sex hormones are affecting your behavior. There is a famous study by Hassett et al. In 2009 where they let monkeys play with toys and looked at what toys they prefer to play with. They found that male monkeys prefer to play with typically boyish toys such as cars and carts, whereas girls or female monkeys had a slightly high preference for what is usually girlish toys, such as dolls. Important thing to point out that for the male monkeys, this was only a slight preference. I think it was about 75% of the monkeys preferred to play with the cars and the carts. And girls actually had an equal preference for the dolls and the cars and carts. But the idea would be that testosterone may make boys prefer more rough and tumble play. And of course, with a car and a cart, you can play more rough. But this, of course, is an animal study, so it's hard to apply to humans. But they have also looked at other studies on this. And there is this study by Hines et al. In 2004, where they looked at children who suffered from congenital adrenal hyperplasia. And this is a disorder where you're exposed to more testosterone or heightened level of testosterone when you're in the womb. And then they looked at those children when they grew up, and they found that girls who had this had CAH actually preferred more rough and rumble play when they were young, and when they were older, they identified with a less traditional gender role. Important thing to point out that for the boys, it made no difference, even though they had been exposed to more testosterone in the womb. They, or prenatally, they did not become more masculine. So that's the biological link. And of course, you all heard about the famous money twin study. The boy they tried to raise as a girl, that didn't turn out so well. But there is also, of course, a psychological aspect, a cognitive aspect. And you're all aware of schema theory and how our beliefs are often our schemas. And the schema is a generalized belief or a mental representation about the world. And through media, through society, through your parents, you develop generalized beliefs or schemas about how girls or how boys should act. And according to BEM's gender schema theory, this affects your perception, like all schemas do, it affects your perception and it affects your memory. And it can also actually affect your self-esteem. So it affects your memory because it changes your expectations and what you see. And a very famous study on this is Martin Halverson in 1983, where they showed pictures to boys and girls with the girls either acting gender consistent or gender inconsistent, and boys acting gender consistent or gender inconsistent. And so gender consistent way would be a boy being dressed as a fireman, and but the gender inconsistent way would be a boy playing nurse or being dressed as a nurse. Contrastingly, it would be a girl being a gender inconsistent would be a girl being a fireman, and a gender consistent would be a girl being a nurse. And then they were asked to recall, like a week after, what they see in those pictures. The participants, they were more likely to remember the gender consistent pictures because of their schemas, because of their gender schemas. But it can also affect your self-esteem because your behavior is in line with the gender expectations, the expectations of gender, it will affect your self-esteem. So there's a lot of pressure from society for us to act in gender consistent ways. And this is, of course, enculturation and socialization. It's an important thing to point out that the concept of gender or gender norms can vary cross-culturally, right? Because they don't only have a biological basis. And it's also something that's learned. Of course, it's the famous Bandura Bobodot study. Like how we model after adults on what's gender appropriate behavior or not. And there is this funny study by Smith and Lloyd in 1978 where they dressed baby girls and baby boys in snow suits that were either pink or blue. But the funny thing was that they dressed the boys in pink snow suits and they dressed the girls in blue snowsuits. And as you know, with babies it's very hard to actually tell the gender because they're so young. And then they have adults interact with them and they observe their behavior. And what they could see is that the girls dressed in blue were encouraged to do more male-typical activity, like physical play and playing with cars, whereas the boys dressed in pink were then encouraged to play with dolls, so the more girlish things. And that, of course, if we're being enculturated or socialized into this at a very early age, it will, of course, have an effect on our behavior. So these are three perspectives on how social roles slash our gender identity is developed. I hope this have helped you in your exploration on this topic. Have a good day!